Hello there, welcome back to Let's Play Lunar, Eternal Blue, Blind. I'm the RPG chick. Start my timer. We're gonna head back from whence we came. I'm gonna show a couple battles just to, for anybody who's just tuning in for the first time, and then I'm just gonna speed all the way there. But what's down here? Anything? I think that's where we're supposed to go. But there's another area. That's pretty cool looking, huh? Maybe that's where we're supposed to end up as. Maybe it goes around? I don't know. And we're gonna go all the way up that little ramp, if you saw it, and then all the way back down. We're gonna see what's down there. Thankfully, we're all at full for everything that we still can't find. What do you call it? Starlights to replenish our mana. They're being really stingy with those. I can't find them in any shops. And I haven't come across any in the game for quite some time, like in chests or anything like that. So, really being stinkers about it. Let's get this for this Fry Chopper first. Alright, she's got this new, well, I went back too far. Lumina has a new crossbow, so we'll check that out. Much better than 6 or 8 points she was doing with that staff, that water staff. Just run right past him. Thanks, Ruby. No thanks to Lucia. Jean, yeah, let's heal her. Back up to go all the way back down and see where. Because I decided to go this way instead. I think we were obviously supposed to go south. But I don't always do what's expected of me. Advantage? Is that. I think that's our advantage. Let's use a little magic to get rid of these things. Well, she is going to cast on the other one. Cool. Hopefully Ronfar hits that one. Good. Bye-bye. The pushovers if you're using magic, but we have no way to replenish our magic, at least not with us. We have to find a statue or something like that to heal up. Wait, oh, back up here too? Oh, those beetles. Let's go magic again, because. To take care of all of them. Oh good, I didn't expect it to take that out. Someone's bound to go up in level, I can feel it. Sheen, I guess, is next. Yeah. Hero's a little low, but I don't think I'm gonna heal him yet. Kind of a waste. Okay. Did we come out of this cave? And I decided to go up instead, right? Let me just check. Yeah. Alright, we never did look and see what was down, or south, or end south. So we will do so now. Oops. It's another city. Oh, it's the other... It's the other side of Takkar. They'll be pissed that we found our way through. It was strange. All the monsters disappeared very suddenly when they heard that Lord Leo was coming. Ha ha ha. Well, that's pretty interesting. Now that the way is open, after going through that haunted mansion, all that stupid stuff to get through. Wish I knew the source of these strange monsters. Now there's a girl named Lamina scamming strangers. She tells them she knows a way around the town and charges them for the info. Ruby says, what? Lamina says, hey, it was not a scam. It was a test for applicants to the Magic Guild. And the money was used to restore the guild. Aren't you the... Yep, I'm Lamina, Premier of the Magic Guild. Sorry you didn't have what it takes to be a member of the Magic Guild. Maybe you can try again someday. Are you kidding? Never. I've had my fill of magic tests. After that terrible experience with the magic trial, I have no desire to be anything other than a tradesman. No desire, I tell you. Oh, the trial at the manor. It was terrible. I still have nightmares about it. The place is haunted now, you know. Lamina says, you are such a lightweight. I'm glad you failed my little test at the manor. Talk about a baby. Ranfra says, well, some people got it and some people don't. He don't. That girl is obsessed by money. I don't think she has any connection to the Magic Guild of Vane at all. Lamina says, that's what you get for thinking. Of course I'm associated with the guild. I'm the junior premier. Ruby says, but premier of what? That place is really run down. I've heard many rumors about the ghost manor lately. Some say that it wasn't real at all, but just put there to test magic ability. I haven't seen the premier of the Money Grubbers Guild. I wonder where she went. She's standing right here, you idiot. That's the Magic Guild, not the Money Grubbers Guild. Ruby says, hey, I think she has you pegged, Lamina. What? You're still hanging around that weird premier of the Magic Guild? You better keep a close eye on her. Lamina says, why should they do that? You're the weirdo. We should keep an eye on you. I love how everyone talks about her like she's not there, and she just answers them. The tradesmen passing through here are saying that the ghost manor is silent. Do you think the ghosts have left? I hope so. It'll be good for business. Let's see if these people have anything new to say. Oh, she just sells stuff, right? Please stop selling starlights. No, thank you. I need money to become a member of the Magic Guild, so I'm saving my earnings. Hopefully I'll have enough when I grow up. Lamina says, well, I'll tell you what. I'll give you this savings book. That way you can deposit your savings with me. I'll keep them in a special account until you get big. Yeah, he keeps on running away. Notice that, huh? Yeah, we're just gonna see if anyone else here has anything new to say, and then we'll head back. I'm so glad the monster situation is eased up. I mean, I like the extra business from stranded travelers, but the threat of danger hanging over our heads was killing me. Harold, this disaster was all your idea. It's nothing but a bore. I never want to go on one of these trips again. Got that? Never. Even though the gate is open again, I think we're too low on money to continue. This time waiting out the monster situation has almost drained us. My wife's gonna kill me. Maybe I can calm her down by getting her some roses. Wrong person. That's a window. Same. Mina says, I think we better pass. We're saving money, and this inn is too expensive. She has new things to say with some of the old dialogues. That woman over there is so beautiful, like a delicate rose. My heart belongs to her, and she doesn't even know it. I do remember that. Think. With a little more work, I'm going to set up my own shop in Takkar. That's step two in my dream to be the most successful merchant in history. Lumina says, sorry, Buster. I think that title goes to me. If selling guild memberships counts. Lord Leo and his men were looking for some people. They said, stop by my inn. Have you seen any unusual-looking visitors? He says, no. No, we haven't seen anything out of the ordinary. Heard about the happenings at the Ghost Manor. So the monster was a fake, huh? That seemed almost too good to be true. I don't suppose there's anything in here that we could use. Okay. So I wasn't sure how to get back up in here. I don't know if these people have anything new to say. Are they kind of removed from all this? Lumina says, I think this money would be put to better use at the Magic Guild. People should start donating to the Magic Guild instead. Then the guild can make this world safe again for everyone. Blasphemy! How dare to speak against the leadership of Althena herself! Blasphemy, I say. What? The monsters have all disappeared from the area? Well then, the power of Althena's cult is greater than I thought. Ruby says, it wasn't you. It was... Lumina says, shh. Ruby, be quiet. They don't need to know. I was thinking that an IRA would be a more prudent investment, don't you think? She's crazy with this money stuff all of a sudden. Let's check over here. In my former life, I was a tradesman, but then I felt the calling. Now I am a servant to the cult of Althena. Donation, please? You what? You gave all your property to these kooks? I can't believe it. We of the Althena cult try to steer the people in the right way. Those that will not donate to the cause will be punished by the goddess. How sweet. That's right, and I bet she left money too. Ruby says, Lumina, I think you're going too far out on that limb. Alright, let's go. So now we gotta go all the way back. Oh, wait a second. Duh. Double duh. I got one more thing to take care of over here. Before I go on our merry way. Done. One for the road. Thinking I might wait to heal up. Yeah, we're not that bad off. Lucia is, but she'll be alright. I'm not completely sure I'm going the right way, but... Yeah, okay, we went up this way. Okay. It's really a twisting, meandering path. I want the dragon wings again so I can just go from one town to another effortlessly. Oops. There, getting close. There's that big gear building thing. Alright, let's heal up here. Head out to the carnival, north of Noka. Oh, it's north of here. North of Nota? Where? What? Not in there. Okay, where? We are north. Ah, is this it? Ah, fun times. Fun times are here. Hi. You're on a giant peppermint candy thing. Well now, boys and girls, come on in and see the best carnival in the known world. There's something for everyone, so step right up and see the sights. Fascinating, Captain. Step right up, one and all. Examine the mystery and beauty of fire. You're looking at the world's best human flamethrower. Watch in amazement as I spew streams of flame high into the air. You're probably the world's only human flamethrower. Ruby says, so he spits fire. Big deal. I can do that too. Wow, it looks like some kind of natural ability you have there. Want to join the carnival? No. Thanks. Then, kids, don't try this at home, okay? A freak of nature can spew flame high in the air. Watch and see. Can't do anything with this. It just made us freak out, that's all. There's balloons over there. Yippee! It's the carnival, dang nabbit. The lights, the smells, I just love it. I've wanted to be a carnival groupie since I was a boy, and my dreams come true. And she says, what are carnival groupies? There's no place in the world I'd rather be than the carnival. I've always been entranced by the lights and music. You didn't answer her question, you rude frickin'. Enjoy our carnival, see the sights, and don't forget to visit the Hall of Chance. Run for us. This is some sort of gambling joint? Woohoo! I'll get my dice. I mean, it says, Ronfar, where's your head? We don't have time to spend gambling. Speaking of party poopers, I'll say that little Miss Money Pants is it. Besides, I can double my money in no time flat. Double? Did you say double your money? Well, maybe we do have just a little time to hang around here. As long as you double my money, too. Ruby says, look at that, hero. Ronfar's got Lamina hooked now. How completely pathetic. Come on in, see the lights, place a bet, take a chance. It's all in good fun. Alright, that's in here. Let's go ahead. Dun, 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 dun. Minigame coming up. Say there, come on over and try your luck with the bones. If you win, you win big. And if you lose, so what? You can play again. Sorry, I don't gamble. Well, why'd you come here in the first place, kid? This ain't no petting zoo. Sure, I'll try it. Ah, just what I'd like to see. Someone who can take control of their destiny. Ronfar says, well then, mister, you won't mind if I ensure my destiny by checking your dice. Oh, no, no. That's not necessary. We're a licensed establishment. There's no cheating here. Okay then, folks. What will you wager? Yeah. Okay, 10 silver. Are you betting your milk money? I haven't seen a bet that small since... Well, okay. Okay, we're all set to play wings and thighs. You just need to pick one. Wings are even, thighs are odd. What do you want to bet on? Wings or thighs? I do like myself a good set of thighs myself. Betting on thighs. Ah, thigh man. I like that. Let's roll the dice and test your luck. Thighs, take your money and don't gloat. Want to play another round? Sure, what the heck. They should be a little bit improvement of this game if they show how much we actually have at the moment. Let's bet 50 silver. 50 silver it is. I like a person that's willing to risk a little. Thigh man. Read him and weep. This round was mine, boys. One more time. Thighs again. Sweet. We got our money back plus 10. Done. You shouldn't leave the table until you give me a chance to win my money back. I did. You failed. This song brings back the sweetest of memories. This was the song my wife used to love. I sang it to her when I proposed marriage. I was such a shy boy, not really sure what I was doing. But I was headed off to war, and I knew that I had to ask her before I left. Hey, that looks like a mighty rare flying cat. Say, why don't you let me put it in our freak gallery? It'll make you rich. Here it comes, guys. Lamina says, stop that silly talk this instant. That's so inhumane, even I wouldn't do it. Says who? Ruby asks. This girl's talking about serious money. Now you're in for it. I'm telling you, a few short months with your cat in a sideshow, and we can all retire. I don't want to hear you suggest that again. I'm not just some dumb animal, you know. She just suggested it again. Dad, what are you still doing drinking here? I want to go play and see the carnival sights. I'm not your father. Hick. Hey, what are you doing invading my space? Don't you know I'm a very important person? Hick. This bar has exotic tonics from all over the world. Try one of our famous tonics before you leave. You won't regret it. I'd like to, but I can't. Don't bother me now. I have to concentrate on this song. La 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 la. When I was alone as one, my eyes were as blind, I know. Sky brilliant with blue elegance, I couldn't behold. When I was alone as one. And, okay, Lucia's singing along, la 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 la. When I was alone as one, my heart was as ice, I know. Mine whispering sweet melodies I could not behold. So I have to check these other tents. Hey, Jean, long time no see, girl. Yeah, long time no see. Say, what happened to you? What's with the outfit? Well, I changed my clothes for the carnival. I wasn't getting much dancing work. But as a bunny girl, I'm really in demand. Isn't that kind of demeaning to women? Well... I heard from Gibbon you won't dance at the carnival this year, Jean. I'm kind of disappointed. I wanted to see you dance again. Hey there, kids. Want one of my colorful balloons? I just made a new batch. The gas inside them can lift you into the sky. Ruby says, Hero, Hero, please, can we get some balloons? I want to fly with one. You can already fly. Ronfor says, what are you talking about, Ruby? You always fly. Ronfor, you are the biggest drag on my enthusiasm. Every adventure party has a pooper. That's why we invited you, party pooper. Say, how about a nice new balloon to brighten your day and lift your spirits? Just made a new batch. Okay, whoa, got stuck in there. Oh, there's something up here, too. Well, anyway, got three more tents to check out. And we are going to do that next episode. Thanks for watching, see you next time, and a bang bang boogie, and don't stop the boogie.